Hello dear chess lovers, today I wanna show you a new game between British Grandmaster Raymond Keane and Austrian Grandmaster Karl Robasch. Robasch died in 2000 when he was 71 years old and Raymond Keane is now 75 years old. When this game was played, Keane was 23 and Robasch was 43 years old. Let's see this party. Keane white pieces, Robasch black pieces. Keane played c4, English opening. C pawn is now controlling d5 central square. Black played knight f6. Black knight is controlling central squares. Knight f3 developing knight and controlling squares on center. e6. Black controlling d5 square and wanted to develop his kingside bishop. g3. White wanted to develop his bishop from long diagonal. d5. Attacking c4 pawn. Grabbing space in the center. Bishop g2. Developing bishop and preparing to castle short. Bishop e7. Developing dark square bishop and preparing to kingside castling. Castle short. And black castle short. d4. Now, grabbing space in the center and preparing to develop dark squared bishop. Knight b2 d7, developing knight. Bishop queen c2. Queen is now defending c4 pawn, also looking at h7 pawn. b6. After b6, black wanted to develop his light squared bishop from long diagonal and after taking c4 pawn with his d pawn, opening the diagonal and exchanging light squared bishops. Knight c3. Knight is developing and controlling squares on center. Bishop b7. Bishop is now defending d5 pawn again. C takes d5. Instead of taking with bishop or pawn, knight takes d5. After knight takes d5, bishop takes d5. e4. And now e pawn is attacking bishop. e4 and d4 pawns are both central pawns and controlling four important squares on the center. Bishop retreated to b7. Bishop b4, bishop f4. Now bishop and queen are attacking c7, black's pawn. c5, attacking d4 pawn. d5, advancing on the center. E takes d5, e takes d5. Now d5 pawn is an isolated pawn. Bishop f6. Instead of taking this isolated pawn, because white has a good move, rook a2 d1, and there's trouble on the d-file for blacks. Black did not take this poisonous pawn and developing his bishop from long diagonal and attacking b2 pawn. Now h4. White wanted to play knight g5 and for providing this, he played h4. Rook e8. Rook is now on e file. Open file for black's rook. Knight jumps to g5. Now both queen and knight are attacking h7 pawn. For defending this, black played knight f8. Rook a2 d1. Both rook and bishop are defending d5 isolated pawn against black's queen and bishop's attack. Bishop d4. Bishop is now preventing rook's defense of d5 pawn. Bishop e3. h6. Attacking white's knight. Knight jumps to e4. And bishop takes bishop. F takes bishop. Now black made a blunder. Knight g5. Instead of this, if he played queen d7. Queen c3, bishop a6, rook f2 e1, and the game is almost equal. But in the game, After knight g6 blunder, white made a sacrifice. Rook takes f7. Now rook is looking at b7 bishop. Black accepted the sacrifice. King takes f7. Rook f1 check. Now black king went to e7 square. Instead of king e7, if black played king g8, knight f6, queen takes f6, rook takes f6, knight e7, rook d6, and white's position is winning. In the game, after king e7, d6, check, king d7, rook f7, now rook on the 7th rank is very effective against black's king, knight e7, queen a4, king c8, d7, forking both king and rook. After queen takes d7, white played bishop h3 and black resigned. If black takes the bishop, after queen takes e8 and white's position is winning. If black plays bishop c6, after queen takes c6, knight takes c6, bishop takes d7, king d8, bishop takes e8, king takes e8, knight d6 check, king d8, rook f8, king d7, rook takes a8, knight takes, king takes d6, and white's position is winning because white has a rook against black's knight. In the game, after bishop h3 move, black resigned and king won this game when he was only 23 years old. If you like this match, like and share this video and subscribe to my channel. See you on later videos. Goodbye.